years I tried to hide from it, avoid it, not discuss it. It's a responsibility to really try to understand what is good and what is evil.
There was this teacher that taught neo-fascism in this school.
Students were so easily coerced into doing something that obviously wasn't right and just took over their lives.
It's the perversion of the incredible power of the human mind that can do almost anything. All the magical things the human mind does in terms of creativity can get perverted to justify any evil, any transgression.
We were chosen out of all his other classes to participate.
The first few days, the third wave was a game. We had lots of rules. We had lots of things we had to do.
One of the first things that he did for us was give us an exercise where we put our hands behind our back and lock them together.
There is a certain strength that comes from discipline. The question is, to what end?
She shared with me that she had been born and raised in Nazi Germany and that this was the climate of her upbringing. And she said, this is so like that, and you can't take the sitting down, you have to do something.
I refused to give him my name. The other guy started to move over like it was actually going to be confrontational. I was getting ready to go to battle. It looked like maybe it was going to be a fist fight right here in the hallway.
He took his advantage as a teacher with a guaranteed audience of young people to try to indoctrinate them. He wasn't teaching them, he was indoctrinating them.
And all of a sudden the class would start chanting in unison, guilty, guilty, guilty.
There was a line crossed all over the place.
What they did they were not proud of. I think that's what hurt a lot of the people.
I thought we were trapped. I went into a panic. I stood up and I said, I'm getting the hell out of here.
And this wasn't about teaching students or running a simulation. This was out of bounds.
And one day he followed me into the faculty room where he was addressed by the English teacher, Mr. Tanner. Mr. Tanner said, you don't belong in here, you're a student. And this child turned to that teacher and said, I'm not a student, I'm a bodyguard.
The truth will finally be revealed. It's an important truth about human behavior, even the human behavior of adults.